Bonds are very tricky. Historically, I like them. Because there's so much debt, it's very hard to see interest rates go up a lot because you start getting into real problems of the interest expense and other things like that. I find the States, you know, contrary to market positioning and sort of recent performance, I find the US very, very troubling and very, very, very problematic. Super problematic. The weird thing about this industry is that, you know, especially with like hedge funds and that sort of stuff, people always think, oh, there's like some magic stuff. And, you know, when you look at all the big trades, it's like, US houses are too expensive, so we short the guys who lent against them. And it's like, I mean, is that hard? Or oil price was like 120 and lots of production was coming on. So now it fell. I mean, these are not mystery trades. It's just that they've continued for so long. People have just sort of accept that they're part of the wallpaper or something like that. So the US is I find that truly extraordinary in that if you look at the US economy now, you got all-time highs in the stock market, more or less, being strong property markets, unbelievably great employment numbers. I mean, fantastic. Now, if you told me all that and then said, Russell, what do you think US fiscal deficit would be? Well, I go, well, you know, back in the dot-com bubble days, you know, they ran a 2% surplus. So, you know, let's say 2% surplus again. And you go, oh, no, it's like a 4.5% deficit. Really? What happens if there's a recession?